Hello, this is Basic Electronics Engineering. The course code is EC201. The contact hour is 3 lecture classes. The total contact hour is 36 hours. The credit point of this subject is 3. Myself, Dr. Indranath Sarkar, I am the Associate Professor in the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering of GIS College of Engineering, Kollani. This course has 4 number of outcomes. We expect the students will be at the end of the course, the student will be able to demonstrate PN junction diode, ideal diode, diode models and its circuit analysis, application of diode and special diodes. The student also will be explained how operational amplifiers are modeled and analyzed and to design operational amplifier circuits to perform operations such as integration, differentiation on electronic signals. The students must analyze the concept of both positive and negative feedback in electronic circuits and its applications. The student must develop the capability to analyze and design simple circuits containing non-linear elements such as transistors, using the concept of load lines, operating points, and the incremental analysis. This course is comprised of 6 number of modules. Each module has the number of class limited, that is 5 number of class assigned to module 1 on basic semiconductors, 7 contact hour assigned to module 2 on PN junction diode and its applications. Module 3 has 8 contact hour on bipolar junction transistor. Module 4 has field effect transistor to describe within 6 contact hour. 8 contact hour assigned to module 5, where feedback and operational amplifier will be discussed. And the 2 contact hour assigned to module 6, where the cathode ray oscilloscope will be discussed. This is the prerequisite required for basic electronics engineering. Normally, prerequisites are essential to understand a certain course. In this case, as the students are entering after class 12 into BTEC courses and the basic electronics engineering is studied in the first year, so here we expect the basic course of electronics engineering progress from the fundamentals of electricity, direct current, derives, devices and circuits, series and parallel circuits, to the study of active and passive components, Ohm's law, Kirchhoff's law, that is Kirchhoff's voltage law and Kirchhoff's current law, as well as Ampere's law. In the modern electronics part of the physics in the 10 plus 2, all these items have been taught. So students should recapitulate these theory as well as mathematical formula before going to opt for basic electronics engineering. So therefore, Kirchhoff's law, especially the Kirchhoff's voltage law and Kirchhoff's current law, as well as Ampere's law, have plenty of applications in the design part of electronics devices. Because basic electronic circuit is normally tells about the component description, that means there are several components exist in basic electronics engineering subject. All these components are defined, its characteristics defined, as well as the combination of such component may produce complex circuitry, and the categories of circuit and its input and output characteristics all have been defined. So basic electronics is an important subject. Here students are going through the description and characteristics of all these components, so that in future whenever they are interested about circuit realization, they shall recall about the characteristics they have studied in basic electronics engineering. And for this subject, the data sheet validation of each of these components are required to be carried out by the student, because some component whatever studied has limited features to be explained within the class, and there are detailed feature exists in the datasheet, if the student is interested to create some model, then student should deal with datasheet. The how to see the datasheet and how what are the parametric values required to observe from the datasheet will be discussed in the class. So basic electronics engineering is one of the important subject for any engineering domain, because nowadays there are many interdisciplinary projects are going on in which some electronic circuitry exist. So irrelevant of the department, electronic circuit may be applied to many issues. So that is why basic electronics has contribution about the basic characteristics understanding for those components. So students must give full attention about the characteristics as well as description, mathematical equation whenever discussed for each of the components. Now in the course outcome and program outcome mapping, we are seeing that there are 12 number of program outcomes which are mapped to the course outcome statements. So here as 4 number of course outcome statement exist for basic electronics engineering, they are having different weightages assigned to each of the column of program outcomes, and here 3 depicts the high weightage assigned for a certain mapping, and 2 means the moderate linking, and 1 stands for the least linking, and when there is no link it is kept vacant with a dashed line. Now basic electronics is the foundation engineering subject, as well as it is the basic engineering subject. It has the uses of modern tools regarding the simulation of the circuits, as well as it has long term relation to the student regarding the implementation of project. So it's a lifelong learning, weightage is very high, as well as various surrounding that is applications in the surrounding environment exist. That is why basic electronics engineering is mostly a foundation subject. That is why at the initial part of the program outcome 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 has a great linkage with basic electronics, as well as program outcome 11 and 12 are also. So if we look at the modern tool uses, as well as the project initiative, as well as the foundation engineering concept, we are getting higher weightage for the basic electronics engineering with those program outcomes. And similarly, if we have some long target, that is after a long duration, we have a target to implement certain circuitry which is useful for the mankind, that type of target may be fulfilled, and that is lifelong learning has a great importance on basic electronics engineering, because we sometimes we have a future target of implementing any circuit or applications for the mankind. So that is why basic electronics are getting higher weightage in that part. The course has objective import fundamental knowledge to understand the basic of semiconductor and components like diode, transistor, FET, MOSFET and operational amplifier. It will be it would build mathematical and numerical background for design of electronic circuit and components value. Students equipped with the knowledge and training provided in the course will be able to participate in the design and development and operation in the different area of electronic systems. So therefore basic electronics has the widest domain of application, because it is dealing with the components which are required to implement electronic circuitry. So all the basic components are included regarding its description, input characteristics, output characteristics. So that is why whenever there is a project related work, basic electronics recalled. So that is why it has a long time application for students of any department, because in any department there is a project realization with electronic circuitry. For any domain, it involves the concept of various components of basic electronics. So therefore, this subject is truly important for any department. Welcome to Field Effect Transistor Module 4 under Basic Electronics Engineering. The topics to be discussed today is the enhancement mode MOSFET construction, enhancement mode MOSFET symbols, basic operation of enhancement mode of MOSFET, p-channel enhancement mode metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistors, and there are summary table. Now, enhancement mode MOSFET construction, if we look into the figure, the p-type substrate is taken, and in the p-type substrate there are two n-type area has been doped. Now, the main thing we should note here is that the channel has not been formed within the substrate. So that is the specialty of enhancement mode of MOSFET operation. So no channel is constructed, p-type substrate is present, and other things are same as depletion region MOSFET. That is, there is a silica layer at the top, and there are two wells which are deposited with metal to form the drain and source terminal, but there is no well digged into the region where gate terminal has been formed, because gate terminal is nothing but the metal deposit made on the silica layer. So these terminals are almost same. But as the channel has not been formed before application of the voltage, we should understand that channel has to be formed. Otherwise, where the drain current will flow? So if the channel is not present, the actual operation of the FET, that is field effect transistor, is impossible. So that is why, how to form the channel? So possible amount of gate voltage is required so that minority charge carriers electron, which are residing in the p-type substrate, will be attracted towards the gate terminal, and once these gate electrons are attracted towards the gate terminal, they will form the bridge between the drain and source terminals. That means the drain and source regions are there, so between them there is a bridge connection required in terms of electrons. That means n channel will be formed. So all these things are possible if sufficient amount of gate voltage or minimum amount of gate voltage is applied as positive voltage through some DC battery. So this is the minimum requirement. So the drain and source connected to the n-doped region. The n-doped regions are not connected via n-channel without an external voltage. The gate connects to the p-doped substrate via a thin insulating layer of silica. The n-doped material lies on a p-doped substrate that may have an additional terminal connection called the substrate terminal. So therefore, it is very much clear that the channel has to be formed by applying a positive voltage, since electrons are needed to be attracted as minority carrier residing in the p-type substrate. So therefore, gate terminal needed to be minimum positive voltage is needed, and for the drain terminal it should be applied positive voltage, otherwise electrons will not be attracted. Therefore, the direction of the current of the drain terminal is towards the drain terminal. That means current is entering into the drain terminal, because the current direction and flow of electron direction are different. That means opposite. So we have seen the silica layer, we have seen the metallic contacts for each of the channel, that is each of the terminal, and n-doped regions are induced into the substrate. That means drain and source has been formed, and there is no channel initially present in the p-type substrate, and there is a substrate terminal at the bottom which is working as a reference terminal, because this substrate terminal is short circuited to ground and source terminals. Now this is the enhancement type of MOSFET symbol. From the symbol it is very much clear that between the drain and source there are two number of breaks in the vertical line. Now why it is made? Because drain and source are not initially connected through the channel, and the substrate is also disconnected from them. So therefore there is no interconnection between drain, source and substrate at the beginning of the operation. That means normal operation does not, that means normal fabrication has no connection between drain and source through the channel. Only the applied voltage in the gate terminal will make the connection between drain and source, that means channel will be formed. So that is why this broken line is effectively representing the disconnection between drain and source. Similarly, if we look into the substrate terminal, there is a arrow direction, and that tells that it is a n-channel JFET, and the same arrow direction is also used at the bottom where the source and substrate are normally connected in all the operations you will see. And these are connected to the ground for the common source operations. Now this is typically the output characteristic and the transfer characteristics for the enhancement mode MOSFET. Now as shown on the right hand side, that we are giving the voltage, that means drain to source voltage, gradually more positive, so that will increase the drain current. But the thing is that we are getting the channel blocked if we apply more and more positive voltage to the channel blocked. If we apply reduced voltage to the gate terminal, that means if the gate terminal voltage is reduced to 0 volt, there will be no connection between drain and source through the channel. So that is why we can say that it is fully blocked, and thereafter there is a transfer characteristics which is also present on the left hand side, and it shows that if the gate to source voltage is gradually increased, we are getting more and more drain current, and it is only possible that the channel has to be formed. So minimum amount of gate voltage is the threshold voltage here, which is representing almost 2.5 approximately. So, or it is 2 volt. It is given that numerically it is 2 volt. So minimum gate to source voltage is the start of the current through the channel. That is, channel will be formed, and thereafter if we apply the drain voltage positive, the electrons will be attracted. So VGS is always positive, and IDSS equal to 0, then VGS is less than VT. As VGS is increased above VT, ID increases. If VGS is kept constant and VDS is increased, then ID saturates IDSS. The saturation level VD sat is reached. So this is the p-channel enhancement type of mode MOSFET. The p-channel enhancement mode MOSFET is similar to the n-channel, except that the voltage polarities and the current directions are reversed. So that is the main thing we need to note here. So VT equal to minus 2 volt, and VGS is gradually more negative voltage will make it possible to increase drain current with respect to the increase of drain to source voltage. So drain to source voltage is increased in the negative direction, obviously, because it has to attract the holes. So therefore it is increased in the negative direction, and the drain current direction is always sensed positive. It is going up. So magnitude has been written in the vertical axis. And one more thing we need to note, that the transfer characteristic shows that gate to source voltage should be at least minimum negative voltage, so that the holes will be attracted from the n-type substrate, where the holes are residing as minority carriers. So all these minority carriers will be attracted towards the gate terminal once we apply sufficient amount of negative voltage. Here it is numerically minus 2 volt, so that the bridge connection between the drain and source will be possible. Thereafter, if we apply drain voltage negative, so holes will be attracted. So in this way, more and more negative voltage in the gate terminal will widen the width of the channel, and thereafter more and more drain terminal negative voltage will attract those holes towards the drain, and the current will be increased. So therefore, the nature of the transfer characteristics is just reverse compared to the in-channel MOSFET. So this is the overall characteristics for the p-channel MOSFET, and these are the summary table for the JFET, dMOSFET and eMOSFET. In case of JFET, it is very much clear that the drain current is given by ID equal to IDSS into 1 minus VGS by VP whole square. The same equation may be utilized for the dMOSFET, but for the eMOSFET it is ID equal to K into VGS minus VGS on the VGS override voltage whole square. So therefore here if we compare the characteristics, it is very much clear that for the JFET we are getting one type of characteristics, for dMOSFET or eMOSFET we are getting some enhancement in the characteristics. That is, it is possible to receive more drain current compared to the drain to source saturation current after the application of certain gate control voltage that will thin the depletion region, so that more and more charge flow is possible through the drain terminal. So this is all about the discussions about the our comparisons. And in the eMOSFET, we should be careful about the symbol. The JFET has a very simple symbol which shows that IG equal to 0 ampere and under ID equal to IS, that is saturation current. And here IG is 0 for depletion the depletion type of MOSFET, and thereafter in enhancement type of MOSFET the vertical line is broken because it is showing that there is no interconnection between drain and source through the channel, because channel has not been formed. Without applying voltage it is not possible to create the channel. And thereafter there is a threshold voltage. So thank you.